Hello, everyone. Welcome to my channel, Behind the Binary. In this session, I would like to explain what is API, how to create APIs in Python using Flask framework. Let's deeply discuss about Flask API. A Flask API in Python refers to a web-based interface built using the Flask framework that allows applications or clients, like web apps, mobile apps, or other services, to interact with a backend server via HTTP requests, like GET, POST, PUT, DELETE. Flask is a lightweight and easy-to-use web framework in Python, perfect for building web applications and REST APIs. It is part of the micro-framework category because it doesn't require tools or libraries beyond what's necessary. An API, Application Programming Interface, is a set of rules that allows one software application to interact with another. A REST API, Representational State Transfer, uses HTTP methods to perform CRUD, create, read, update, delete operations on resources. Flask API is lightweight and simple. Minimal setup required. Extensible with many plugins. And also great for rapid development. Key features of Flask API are app.route is to decorator define routes. Get, post, etc. HTTP methods are also supported. JSON EFE function returns a JSON response. Request.get_JSON function parses incoming JSON data. Use cases of Flask API is to develop backend for mobile apps, to develop web services, to develop data APIs for frontend like React, Angular, etc., to develop internal microservices. Let's get into the topic. I have created a folder named Flask API and opened in Visual Studio Code. Also created a virtual env and activated scripts. For creating virtual environment and activate the scripts, I'm displaying the commands on screen. And also I have installed required libraries, which is also displaying on screen. I have created two files named flaskapi.py and data.json. I'm adding some dummy data to test the API calls to data.json file. Also, I am importing required libraries from Flask in Flask API file. Also importing JSON to read the JSON data from data.json file. Here I'm reading the data from JSON file and appending into a list named items. Later we can return this items list in get call. Now I'm assigning the file to the items list. JSON.load function will loads the data from file to list. Now we have to define the app for setting up the API. Into this app variable I'm storing Flask API and giving the name as Flask API. Whichever the name has given here in the app declaration throughout this API, this same name will be used. For example, for logging the errors and debugging, etc. Now I'm creating the API call named getItems using app.routeDecorator. Inside this decorator, we can declare the route of current API call and we can define which type HTTP method it is. AM defining items as route and get as HTTP method. Let's also create a function to return the JSON data which we loaded into items. Inside this function getItems, I'm returning the JSON data of items list which we already retrieved from JSON file. This method now acts as HTTP get method. Later, once we created the method, we have to define the main function to set up this Flask API to run at startup. Likewise here, I'm creating the main method to execute this Flask API. Here the main method is already created and now I'm calling app.run function to execute this API. We can define debug as true to debug while development. And also we can define the host whichever we want, as well as we can define the port. Here I'm defining the host as all zeros, and giving the port number as 5000. After creating this app run, we can execute and call this API as running Flask API Python file. Command will be python filename.py. After successful execution of API, we can run and test this from Postman. I am now trying to call this get API call from Postman. You can observe the output. The data is coming from API whichever we loaded and returned from items list. Now let's try the post call. In the post call, similar to the get API call, we have to define the route here. I am creating a method which add a new item after calling this API as post. I am reading the data from response body using request.get_json method. After reading, we can add the same item to the existing list, or else we create a new item to add to the items. I have created a new item similar to the existing item, and am appending this to existing items list. After appending, am returning the new item in the response. This API call is now required a JSON request. Let's pass a dummy request and see what will happen. After passing the JSON request, you can now observe the output in response body. It is showing created because am returning 201 if it gets success. Similarly, instead creating new item, let's append the JSON request object to the existing item. Now I am appending the request body object to the existing item and returning all items to the response. Let's observe the output. You can now observe the new item from the request body is appended to the response. Let's validate the content from the request body. If the body is not being sent from request, we can return as bad request. Also, we can check the data inside body. If the content of data is none or zero, we can send back the failed response. Here I'm returning 500 if the body is empty. Let's take a look how this validation works. When I'm sending the empty data with empty list, it will return old items, but it will not append anything. But when I remove entire list from request, it should throw error because we have added validation for that. Similarly, I am adding the validation for data length inside the JSON request body. If there is no data inside body, it will throw the error. Let's check how this both validations are working in the Postman. Here you can observe the errors. I'm changing the verbiage to differentiate both errors. If there is no body at all, it will throw the error as request body is required. But if there is no data inside body, it will throw the error as data is required. Now both validations are working perfect as expected. This is how the API calls will work in Python Flask framework. We can read the request body if we want. Without body, also we can create the API call. Let's see how to work around to make token-based authentication for Flask API. JWT, JSON Web Token, is a secure way to transmit information between two parties, like a client and a server, as a JSON object, typically used for authentication and authorization in web applications. The JWT flow works as follows. First, the user sends their username and password to the Flask API. Once the credentials are validated, the server generates a JWT token and sends it back to the user in the response. For accessing other secured API endpoints, the user must include this token in the authorization header as a bearer token. On subsequent API calls, the server validates the token and, if it's valid, processes the request and returns the appropriate response. Let's check how to add this token-based authentication in Flask API. Install the required library, which is Flask-JWT-Extended. After installing the required library, import required objects from JWT-Extended. I am keeping only get call in the API and removing the post call to check this token logic in API. We have to create a secret token, which is JWT_secret_key, which is used to generate the token throughout this API calls. After creating the token, we need to initialize the JWT object using the JWT manager. This object helps handle all JWT-related operations, such as token creation, validation, and access control within the Flask application. Here, I am creating a user object that holds the username and password, which will be used to validate user credentials during the login process. Here, I am creating a Post API endpoint to handle the login process. In this endpoint, the server receives the username and password from the client in the request body. It then validates these credentials against the stored user data. If the credentials are correct, a JWT token is generated and returned in the response. This token will be used to authenticate future requests to protected routes. After successful authentication, the server generates a JWT token and sends it back to the client as part of the response. This token serves as a proof of authentication and should be included by the client in the authorization header of future requests to access protected routes or resources. Now, I am protecting the /items route using the @JWT_acquired decorator. This ensures that only requests containing a valid JWT token in the authorization header are allowed to access this endpoint. If the token is missing, expired, or invalid, the request will be rejected with an unauthorized error. Now, let's validate these methods by first calling the login endpoint to obtain a JWT token. Once we receive the token, we can use it to access the protected routes by including it in the authorization header as a bearer token. This process will confirm that authentication and token-based authorization are working as expected. Here I'm passing the request body from Postman, which are username and password, which validates the login logic and sends back the token. The issue here is that JWT configuration keys must always be written in uppercase letters. If the keys, like JWT_key, JWT expires, etc., are not in all caps, the Flask app will not detect or apply them correctly, and the JWT functionality may not work as expected. Now that we have received the JWT token from the login process, we can send this token in the authorization header of the /items API call to retrieve the result. This demonstrates how the token is used to access protected routes and ensures that only authenticated users can access the /items endpoint. In a typical Flask API using JWT, JSON Web Token, for authentication, the workflow involves 1. User authentication. A post/login API receives a username and password. If credentials are valid, the server generates a JWT token using create_access_token and sends it back in the response. 2. Token usage. The client stores the token, example in local storage or memory. For all protected API calls, the token must be sent in the authorization header. 3. Protecting routes. Use the @JWT_acquired decorator on routes like /items to restrict access to authenticated users only. Flask-JWT-Extended will automatically validate the token. If valid, access is granted. If invalid or expired, returns 401 unauthorized. 4. Configuration. JWT settings, like JWT_secret_key, must be uppercase in the app config to work correctly.